We decided that we wanted to grow vegetables throughout the year. So we decided to go for a greenhouse structure, but we went for a semi-greenhouse structure.
Nagesh ji, I called him from Naval Dockyard and he helped me build this monster shed that we have built.
It is said that the Egyptians were the very first to try building greenhouses. But the earliest written proof is from the Roman Empire, dated 17 to 30 AD. The structures today we see as greenhouses were developed much later in the 1800s after the discovery of glaze and glass. Since then, the materials used and the structural designs have changed a lot, but the purpose has been the same. The sun's rays heats up the earth's surface. Some of the heat reflected back from the ground is trapped either by some gases or by a roof structure. This is termed as greenhouse effect. Now, why is the greenhouse effect said to cause global warming? Not because the effect is negative by itself. It is this effect which makes our planet a conducive place for us to live in. It is a very fragile balance that is needed to maintain this. Now, because of various reasons like pollution, some gases have increased in volume. This has upset the equilibrium, causing an increased greenhouse effect on the planet.
What is a greenhouse? Any enclosed structure where plants are grown. The main advantage or the main reason why somebody would grow in a greenhouse structure is to have a very completely controlled weather condition. Be it extreme temperatures of cold or warmth, you could grow inside a greenhouse. We can control the parameters of temperature, humidity inside a greenhouse structure. Other reasons being disease and pest management is easier. Having a raised bed with drip irrigation system is also easier to maintain and install as well. Another reason for growing inside a greenhouse structure is that it traps heat inside the structure so that the temperature and humidity raises to some extent. It is very supportive for increasing the metabolism of the plant. The growth is many times faster than the usual and the yield is also more. The environmentalists use the term greenhouse effect for the planet because all these emissions of carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, methane, CFC, these are all trapped by the atmosphere. The heat is not able to go out of the atmosphere, atmospheric layer. Hence, there are the increase in temperature. This is called as greenhouse effect by the environmentalist. Unless you're growing a temperate crop which needs specific temperature and humidity requirements, there is no need for a shade greenhouse structure in a place like Maharashtra. And only if you want to grow crops through the monsoon season, which is from June, July till September, October, then you would need a greenhouse structure. So people in Mumbai would have noticed that during the monsoon seasons, the varieties of fresh vegetables that are usually available during the rest of the year is very less during the monsoons. Except for paddy, no other crop is majorly grown in Maharashtra. We decided that we wanted to grow vegetables throughout the year. So we decided to go for a greenhouse structure, but we went for a semi-greenhouse structure. So we decided to go for a top layer, which will be covered with the roofing material, and the sides we wanted to just cover with shade net so that there is a little bit of movement of air inside the greenhouse structure. Three reasons why we wanted to go with this kind of structure is because we were doing this only for protecting the crops during the monsoon seasons from the rains. And number two, if we cover the sides also, it will become quite expensive to maintain the temperature and humidity throughout the year or through the season. There was no need for us to do that because we were going to grow vegetables which are quite accustomed to these weather conditions. The reason three is comparatively this is cheaper than a complete greenhouse structure. We wanted to do something which can be replicable by the farmers around here, and we didn't want to set an example by going in for a very expensive structure. Talking about expense, when we decided that we want to build this structure, we invited a few companies and they came, looked at the site, and they gave a few quotations. It was very exorbitant. What they quoted was totally very high.
Quotes ranged from 15 lakhs to about 30 lakhs. The point was not about the money. The more it was, once we make it and give it to you, once it's ready, after that, we're not interested what happens to it. And that was a problem for me because it's a huge amount.
Of course, the government has lots of subsidies, which the government is giving to the farmers. But the very procedure and the paperwork that's needed to put your to get the subsidy is too long that we didn't want to wait for that.
So then I finally, we went to a lot of greenhouses and saw. And then we decided that what we basically wanted to do, Swami and I decided, let's make a basic shed which stays through the rain and our vegetables can grow peacefully. At the same time, we don't spend too much on the construction.
So we decided to design our own structure. Ashim sir came up with the design.
We did a very rudimentary design in a very house thatched manner. And this is the basic design for most of the greenhouses. And since it's not a poly house, that's why we were not looking at the aerodynamics and all that stuff. That's how we came to the design. So design is very simple. It's like a V-shaped roof. And I've in my poly house, if you see, I've given an adequate height. It's more than it's required because if you're going to do any vegetables on creepers, they will grow well and they will prosper. So that's the basic aim of it. The second aim of having a higher height greenhouse is by having an 18 feet high greenhouse, what we are ensuring is at any given point in time in future, if we want to do layers, multi-layer or layered farming in-house, we can do it. And it's geared up for that. So when we went about constructing this thing, the whole problem started is how are we going to make it a unit that is strong? So I went back to my engineering days and I went to Naval Dockyard. That's where I've done my engineering. And from there, someone who has taught me the basic of pipe fitting, it's a course. And he was our tutor. So Nagesh ji, I called him from Naval Dockyard and he helped me build this monster shed that we have built.
He came and we went and visited the land once. And then he was the one who executed the plan.
It's strong, it's sturdy, it's lasted through one cyclone, though we had a few damages, but it's fantastic. And for that, we've got to thank Nagesh ji.